This video was created with the support of our incredible patrons, who inspire us to carry on when times are hard. We truly appreciate each and every one of you. Hello and welcome to another gameplay video brought to you by Affinity for Commander. My name's Martin.
And my name is Alex.
This week we are doing something a little different in order to support a worthy cause, a game of Oathbreaker. For those of you that don't know, Oathbreaker is similar to Commander, but with a few very important differences. For instance, players start at 20 life instead of 40, and play with decks containing 60 cards instead of 100. Also, your commander is replaced with an Oathbreaker, which has to be a planeswalker rather than a legendary creature. You also have access to a signature spell, which sits in your command zone with your Oathbreaker and can only be cast when your Oathbreaker is on the battlefield. We'll put a link to the complete rules document in the video's description. We weren't sure what to expect when we sat down to play our first ever games, but we were pleasantly surprised by how fun and interesting the format turned out to be.
But this video has a more important message than simply introducing you fine people to the newest MTG format. We have created this video as part of Weird Cards Magic Kids Oathbreaker fundraising campaign, which aims to raise funds for Magic Kids and Children's Miracle Network hospitals. You can find links to these charities in the description of this video, and we ask that you take a moment of your time to take a look at them and donate to their cause if you are able. With that being said, let's start the game of Oathbreaker by taking a look at those opening hands.
My Oathbreaker is Kiora, Master of the Depths, and my signature spell is Heroic Intervention. I keep an opening hand of Harbinger of the Tides, Lord of Atlantis, Merfolk Branchwalker, Botanical Sanctum, Simic Guildgate, Yavimir Coast, and an island.
My Oathbreaker is Tamio, Field Researcher, and my signature spell is Cord of Calling. My opening hand contains Lanoir Elves, Eternal Witness, Dousing Dagger, a Plains, an Island, and two Forests.
Liam is playing a deck headed by Sarkhan Unbroken and is using Team of Battle Rage as his signature spell. He keeps an opening hand containing Eternal Witness, Atarka World Render, Wilderness Reclamation, Stubborn Denial, Reliquary Tower, and two Forests.
And finally, Sol's Oathbreaker is Nissa, who shakes the world, using Wildest Dreams as his signature spell. He keeps an opening hand containing Nantuko Cultivator, Endless Atlas, Abundance, Uncaged Menagerie, and three Forests. I win the die roll and decide to go first. I play a forest and cast Lanoir Elves, and pass to Sol.
Sol also plays a forest and then ends his turn.
Not wanting to stand out, Liam plays a forest and passes the turn.
I break the trend of playing forests and instead play Simic Guildgate. I then pass to Alex.
I play an island, cast Avacyn's Pilgrim, and then cast Dousing Dagger. I choose Sol to get 2/0/2 plants and then end my turn.
Sol plays a forest and then casts Endless Atlas. He then passes to Liam.
Liam plays Command Tower and then passes the turn.
I play Botanical Sanctum and cast Merfolk Branchwalker. I reveal the top card of my library to be Thornwood Falls, put it into my hand, and end my turn.
I play a Plains, and then cast my Oathbreaker, Tamio, Field Researcher. I use her plus one ability, targeting my Elves and Martin's Merfolk, and then move to combat. I attack Liam with my Elves, dealing him one damage and drawing a card from Tamio's ability. I then pass to Sol.
Sol plays a Forest, and then uses his Endless Atlas to draw a card. He then passes the turn.
Liam plays a forest, and then ends his turn.
I play an island, and then cast Merfolk Sovereign. Moving to combat, I attack Tamio with my Branchwalker, dealing her 3 damage. Alex draws a card, and I then pass the turn.
I equip my dagger to Avacyn's Pilgrim, and then activate Tamio's ability, targeting the Pilgrim and Martin's Sovereign. Moving to combat, I attack Martin with my Pilgrim, and he blocks with the Sovereign, resulting in the death of both creatures. I draw 2 cards and move to my post-combat main phase, where I play a Breeding Pool. I lose 2 life to have it enter untapped, and cast Birds of Paradise, followed by Thrumming Bird. I then end my turn.
Sol plays a forest and then casts Broken Bond, targeting Dowsing Dagger. The dagger is destroyed and Sol puts a forest into play with the spell's effect. Sol then uses his Atlas to draw a card and passes the turn.
Liam plays a forest, and then casts Wilderness Reclamation. He then untaps all of his land in his end step and passes to Martin.
I play Yavimir Coast and then cast Lord of Atlantis. next I cast Harbinger of the Tides, paying a life to tap Yavimir Coast for blue, and return Alex's Llanowar Elves to his hand.
Rude.
Moving to combat, I attack Tamio with my Branchwalker, and Alex is unable to block given that my merfolk has Island Walk. Tamio's loyalty hits zero, and I end my turn.
I play a forest, and then move to combat. I attack Martin with Thrumming Bird, dealing him 1 damage. I then move to my post-combat main phase. Next, I cast Eternal Witness, returning Dowsing Dagger to my hand. I then recast the dagger, this time choosing to give Liam the plant tokens, and then recast Llanowar Elves before passing to Sol.
Sol plays a forest and then casts his Oathbreaker, Nissa Who Shakes the World. He uses her +1 ability to untap a forest and put 3 +1/+1 counters on it, and then casts Abundance before passing the turn.
Liam plays Carplusen Forest, which he then loses a life in order to cast his Oathbreaker, Sarkhan Unbroken. He uses his +1 ability to draw a card and add green mana to his mana pool before using it to cast Ulvenwald Tracker. Moving to his end step, Liam untaps his land and passes to Martin.
Feeling left out, I also cast my Oathbreaker, Kiora, Master of the Depths. Next I play Thornwood Falls, gaining a life, and then move to combat. I attack Liam with my Harbinger and Alex with my Branchwalker, dealing them both 3 damage. In my second main phase, I use Kiora's +1 ability to untap Thornwood Falls and Harbinger of the Tides before ending my turn.
I play Nimbus Maze and then recast Tamio. I use her +1 ability, targeting Thrumming Bird and Harbinger of the Tides, and then equip my dagger to Thrumming Bird. Moving to combat, I attack Martin with the Bird Horror, dealing him 3 damage. Dowsing Dagger then transforms into Lost Veil, and I proliferate the loyalty counters on Tamio before drawing a card thanks to her ability. Not yet finished, I cast Kefnet the Mindful, and then pass the turn.
Sol draws a non-land card with Abundance, plays a forest, and then casts Worm Calling, where X is 13. Not liking the sound of this, Liam casts Stubborn Denial, countering the spell. Not to be deterred, Sol uses Nissa's +1 ability, untapping a forest and putting 3 +1/+1 counters on it. He then uses his Atlas to draw a card and passes to Liam.
Liam uses Sarkhan's +1 ability, drawing a card and adding a red mana to his mana pool. He then plays Reliquary Tower and casts Eternal Witness, returning Stubborn Denial to his hand. Next, he casts Low Skill Coatl, untaps his land, and ends his turn.
I play a forest and then cast Seafloor Oracle. Moving to combat, I attack Nissa with 3 of my fish people and Sol blocks 2 of them with his plants. Nissa takes 2 damage, Alex draws a card, and I move to my post-combat main phase. I propose that Alex and I stop our fighting for the time being, which he agrees to, and then cast Merrow Commerce. Liam considers countering the enchantment, but I quickly deter him by threatening to send all of my creatures at him next turn if he does. Diplomacy in action. I then use Kiora's +1 ability to untap Botanical Sanctum and Harbinger of the Tides, untap all of my creatures in my end step, and pass to Alex.
I play Hinterland Harbor and then move to combat. I attack Sol with Throwing Bird, dealing him 1 damage, and proliferating the loyalty counters on Tamio. Everyone else groans as the realization of what is about to happen sinks in, and move to my second main phase. I use Tamio's -7 ability, drawing 3 cards and gaining an emblem that is essentially Omniscience. I then cry about the quality of cards that I just drew, discard down to 7, and pass the turn.
Sol draws an on-land card, and plays a forest surprising no one. He then casts Uncage the Menagerie, where X is 6. We all agree that it would be best if the spell didn't resolve, and Alex attempts to bargain with Liam and myself in exchange for countering it. We reject his negotiations, knowing full well that any creature Sol searches for will be used to take down Alex, which Sol confirms to be true. Defeated, Alex flashes in Frilled Mystic, countering the spell of his Elf Lizard Wizard. Undeterred, Sol once again uses Nissa's +1 ability, animating a forest, and then casts Wolfbriar Elemental, kicking it 6 times. Wow, these are some scary plays. He makes 6 2/2 wolf tokens, and then ends his turn.
Liam draws a card and puts a +1/+1 counter on his snake. He then uses Sarkhan's +1 ability, adding green, no red, no green, no blue to his mana pool. Draws a card, puts another +1/+1 counter on his snake, and plays a forest. Liam then casts a Tarka, World Render, absolutely terrifying the rest of the table. Satisfied with our responses to his dragon, Liam passes the turn, untapping all his land in his end step.
I move straight to combat, and Alex stops me by asking if I plan on attacking him. I respond with a strong maybe, and Alex reluctantly passes priority. I send all of my merfolk at Alex, given that he is the only player that can't block them, and Liam responds by using his tracker's ability to make my seafloor oracle fight as a talker. The oracle is obliterated, and Alex activates Kefnet's ability to draw a card. He does this once more, cycles Scattered Grove, and then takes 8 damage. In my post-combat main phase, I cast Kamena, Tyrant of Araska, followed by Shapers of Nature, and then use Kiora's plus 1 ability to untap a land and a creature. Not quite finished, I tap 3 merfolk to draw a card using Kamena's ability, and then untap all of my creatures in my end step before passing to Alex.
I cast my Oathbreaker for a third time, and use her plus 1 ability targeting Kefnet and Thumbing Bird. Moving to combat, I attack Martin with the aforementioned creatures, dealing him 6 damage. I draw 2 cards, proliferate Tamiyo's loyalty counters, and move to my second main phase. Here, I cast Tireless Tracker, followed by Mole Drifter, drawing 2 cards from his ETB. Not yet finished, I cast Flicker Wisp, exiling Mole Drifter until the end of turn. I then cast Derevi, Imperial Tactician, untapping Kefnet with her ability. I play Flooded Strand, and then make a clue. Finally finished, I move to my end step, returning Mole Drifter to the battlefield and drawing 2 cards before passing the turn.
Sol chooses to draw a land, plays a forest, and then casts his signature spell, Wildest Dreams, where X is 2. He returns Uncaged Menagerie and Wormcalling to his hand, uses Nissa's plus 1 ability on a forest, and casts Uncaged Menagerie, where X is 6. There must be some fantastic 6 drops in Sol's deck for him to want them so badly. Alex responds by flashing an Aven Mind Sensor, allowing Sol to only search the top 4 cards of his library. That's 2 weeks in a row this bird wizard has ruined someone's day. Sol fails to find any 6 CMC creatures, and then casts Wormcalling, where X is 6. This spell resolves, and Sol makes a 6-6 worm before moving to combat. Sol asks for temporary immunity from Liam and myself in order to swing his army at Alex, and we both agree. Alex is not too pleased by this and casts his signature spell, Cord of Calling, where X is 4. Liam moves to counter the cord, but Alex strikes a deal with him to let it resolve, and Liam is persuaded to do just that. Alex then searches his library for Magus of the Moat and puts it into play, preventing Sol's army of wolves from attacking. We plead with Liam to remove the Magus by forcing it to fight a Tarka, but Liam refuses. Well, there goes that plan. Sol then passes the turn, and Liam responds by flashing in Surak Dragonclaw before proceeding to his turn.
Liam draws a card, putting a plus one counter on Lorskill Coatl, and then uses Sarkhan's plus 1 ability. He makes a green mana, draws a card, and puts another plus one counter on his Coatl before playing Mosswort Bridge. Liam exiles a card underneath the land and casts Secure Tribe Elder. He immediately sacrifices the Snake Shaman and searches the top 4 cards of his library for a basic land. Risky. Liam finds an island, puts it into play tapped, untaps his land, and then passes to Martin. Martin responds by tapping 5 merfolk to put a plus one counter on each of his merfolk, and then moves to his turn.
I cast Tezzeret's Gambit, to which Liam responds by casting Stubborn Denial. No ultimating Kiora this turn, I guess. Next, I use Kiora's plus 1 ability to untap a land and cast Jadelight Ranger, exploring twice. I reveal an island, followed by another island, and then tap 3 merfolk to draw a card. I tap 3 more merfolk to draw once more and move to my end step, where I untap all of my creatures. Alex responds by flashing in Stunt Double, having it enter as a copy of a Tarka, and then proceeds to his turn.
I play Temple of the False God, and activate Tamiyo's minus 2 ability to tap a Tarka and Ulvermore Tracker. Liam responds by using the tracker to have both Atarkas fight each other, to which I respond by casting my signature spell once more, where X is 4. I search my library for Shalai, Voice of Plenty, and put her onto the battlefield, and watch Liam's tracker lose its target. Shame for him, really. I then cast Triumph of the Hordes, causing Martin to have a mini meltdown.
I hate that card.
Moving to combat, I attack Martin with Atarka, Sol with Kefnet and Flickerwisp, and Liam with everything else, killing everyone with infect damage in one swing. And that, my dear viewers, is how you win games and lose friends.
Well, that's it for our first encounter with Oathbreaker. It was certainly an enjoyable way of playing Magic, with signature spells adding an extra layer of complexity and synergy to deck building. We'd like to give special thanks to Sumner Magruder for getting in touch with us about making this video, as well as to the entire team at Weird Cards for the fantastic work that they do. If you want to learn more about what it is that the Weird Cards team do, or want to support their work with a donation, the links to do so will be in the description of this video. We'll see you next time!